My name is Heather Grimaldi. I am the Programs Manager for Kidspace Children's Museum.
My name is Alberto Hernandez. I teach kindergarten dual language in East Los Angeles.
I'm John Ramirez with AES. I'm a float designer, and I just built a float with first graders.
This year in 2020 in particular, it's been so difficult for the kids having to have class via Zoom. It's much harder for them to connect with their teachers and their other classmates.
As an educator, I need to learn the technology. I need to learn different strategies. It's been a challenge for me.
So how are we going to create a program that really connects with the students and brings that fun and interest into their classroom? The best way to do it is by building floats.
What did I think when I learned that my class would be helping to build a float was, this is amazing.
This float building program incorporated three different classes of students, one class of kindergartners, one class of combined first and second graders, and one class of all first graders. We took the kids through a real float build from design to drive over the course of a 12-week program, and they got to lead the entire creative process.
In this project, the students came up with the theme, which was best day ever. And when working with the students and asking them what was that message they wanted to convey, it was all about going places and experiencing joy. Road trips, trips on airplanes, seeing the world, and that was all great stuff. And those were the elements we used to decorate our float.
The nice thing about STEAM is that it's science, technology, engineering, art, and math. We can do storytelling as part of art. We used math with grid making and pre-math skills with our students while we're designing certain aspects of the float. The science and technology behind animation and movement within the float all really clicked with this program.
Sebastian, I see your hand up. What's something that floats have?
Stories.
They tell stories. Right? And the colors help us tell the story, and they help with the decorations.
The kids were really easy to work with, and that helped in completing our going places float in record time.
Engineering and design are made for project-based learning. STEAM is made for project-based learning because you're asking a question, you're looking for solutions, you get to try out so many different ways to make it work, and then be able to show your proof that, yes, I figured out how to answer that question.
This project does what I think education is meant to be. It takes every particular aspect of STEAM and it ties it all together. Why it's important to know the math, the technology, especially the engineering, and how it can come together to build something and solve a problem and tell a story, and really students can express anything they want in terms of putting these elements together.
When students get to participate in project-based learning, you can see the wheels turn in their head when they start thinking about all the different ways that they can think through a problem. You can see them work through frustration when it just doesn't work the way that they want. And you can see that joy and pride within themselves when they fully make it happen.
Finally, all of the elements started to come together. I think they're going to be really excited to see the final float.
Thank you.
I think this float turned out amazing. I had such high hopes that these kids would absolutely love the thing that they got to create. And seeing their faces, they're just so enamored of this amazing project that they got to have a hand in.
There was never a moment where there wasn't expressions of thinking, of wondering, and of course, seeing the smiles on the students' faces.
I can't wait to do it again.